Step number six, sell sheets. This is the most important tool you'll ever need to license an idea. Now, a lot of sell sheets I see from inventors and entrepreneurs, they put on how big the market is. They put all this other information in there. No. Make a sell sheet for why customers are going to want it. Look at all the ads in magazines. Those are all sell sheets, right? When you go to a trade show, you hand out, those are sell sheets, right? So those are great tools. It's one page, it's easy. What I love about sell sheets now, I used to mail them to companies. I don't do that anymore. I send it off electronically now. I don't even have to mail it anymore. And you know what else I do? I embed in my sell sheets a little video now too. So not only do you see the sell sheet, click on it, and now you see the 1 minute video of the pain and the solution. The goal of a sell sheet is to get the guy to call back. That's all it really is. I want to know more. And the reason why you do that, because now you have a dialogue going on. I get to know the guy. And once I start talking to him on the phone, I can start asking him questions about his business. I build a relationship. What college do your kids go to? I can ask them about different questions about their company. I can do all these things if I have a dialogue. But if I don't have this dialogue going on, it's really hard, right? But a sell sheet will do that for you. The bottom line is, make it intriguing, make it where people want more. And when I do a sell sheet, what I like to do also, I'll find an existing idea that I really like, or maybe my potential licensee I want to go after, and I go to their website, look what colors they use, what fonts they use. How does it feel? And then I'll send that over to my designer and go, you know, I'm going to send it to this company. I want it to make it look and feel just like one of their products. So when they get it, they go, wow, this looks just like our stuff. I can imagine this plugging this right into my product line. So those sell sheets can be very, 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 very powerful, but make sure you design them correctly, especially when you're going to fit it to that correct potential licensee. You know, if you create a sell sheet, give it to somebody right away. If you're in a company, give it to someone and say, look, do you understand it? And you'd be surprised that you might really love something and you might think it's on track, but when you give it to somebody else, they don't know what they're looking at. So do yourself a favor, hand it to someone else, right, and say, look, do you understand this? And make sure they understand it that fast. And if they don't, redesign again, because you haven't hit it right. And you know what happens? Because I design, I'm doing my work so close that sometimes I miss something, right? So always get second opinions and third opinions. And you'd be surprised, you can just make it look better. But I never send a sell sheet to a company that I haven't contacted. You know, if you do, you know what it's called? It's called junk mail. People won't open it. Let your product sell itself, always, because even if you're in a meeting, you gotta leave. You need to leave something behind that they're gonna look at and they're gonna talk about. And especially if it's on a computer now, they can send it to everybody internally, and they're all looking at it now.